Introduce your character.
I'm an elf barbarian.
Yeah, okay. I'm an elf barbarian named...
Barb.
Barb.
No. Steph.
Hey, give Barb a chance.
Exactly. Okay? I know what I said. I said Barb. Love to all and welcome everybody. My name is BlacKHaLLoW and this is Life is Strange Before the Storm. Now I know that this is a new series to the channel, you guys, but believe me when I say that the original to this game, it changed my life. Like, it was one of the best games I had ever played. It's along the same lines of Telltale, which is decision-based, interactive, story-rich gameplay. So we're going to be diving in today. But before we do, I would just like to say that before you click off, because there is another season, quote-unquote, to this. This particular one is actually a prequel. So if you would like to jump along for the ride, and that is the reason why I decided I wanted to play it. If you want to jump along for the ride and experience it in a different way, watch what happens before what happens next, and then go experience what happens next for yourself, then I hope you buckle up because it is going to be a crazy ride. Let's go to episodes. There's going to be three of them, okay? And we're going to be playing, well, you know what? Actually, I'll just let the game do what the game is going to do because... We're gonna see who we're playing as. Life is Strange Before the Storm is a story-based game that features player choice. The consequences of your actions and decisions will impact the world around you. Choose wisely. Oh, and the first fucking thing they do is light up a smoke. Tell me a joke. Light up my smoke. Okay, all right. You know, none of the Billy Joel shit. I still think that's ironic. No. No. Oh, and God damn it, I forgot to turn on subtitles. I just realized they haven't even said anything yet. Okay, is this some sort of I feel alive shit, or can we jump out of the way now? I'm ready on the QTE. Oh, I'm so ready. Okay, hippity hop, that's the QTE. Alrighty. And you know what I'm also realizing is that, vibrations turn on my controller. So I'm gonna have to change that in just a second here because I'm not good at QTEs on the controller and I don't want to be holding this thing. I want to set it down and go back to the...
Firewalk is playing a show at the old mill. Fuck yes.
Alrighty, well, it would appear I did not forget the...
Mom would kill me if she knew I was out here.
Oh yeah, she probably would, knowing your mom. We gotta go to the game settings. Vibration, we'll turn that off. There we go. Okay, and the subtitles are already on there. Beautiful. Now I can set the controller down and come back to the mouse. Fantastic. Batman, Telltale, all the other games, they kind of skewed my QTE reflexes. Fence! Yes, it is a fence. Are we gonna go over the fence? Is it an electric fence? It's a barbed wire fence. We're gonna jump the fence, okay?
No trespassing? No way.
Hazardous conditions exist.
No trespassing? No way.
Okay, so walking forward. Oh, press S to jump it. Press S to jump. I see the jump now. It was blending in. My bad. It's been a while since I played Life is Strange. The font is different and the UI is different. It's gonna take me just a minute to get back into the rhythm of things.
Shit.
So good to see Chloe again, though, for real. Hey! Light show! Totally is a party. Damn. Or it's a show, rather.
This place is awesome.
Hey, you said it. Looks pretty cool. Alright, let's go over here. Hold shift to move faster.
I'll have to get through that door.
That door right there? Okay, we'll figure it out. Yeah, holding shift to move faster, that's something that you... Oh, machinery. We're gonna do something with that in a minute here. We got some cars over here. That's something that most people don't even know about any of the Telltale games or the Square Enix story-based games like Life is Strange. And that is you can hold shift to run faster. It's easily missable. Betting stub. Hey, yeah. Yeah, let's get the betting stub.
If I owed somebody $1,000, I'd be shitting my pants.
That doesn't... Yeah, let's put that back where we found it. And because I don't owe anybody $1,000. Okay, you know what? The game wants me to probably talk to this guy and establish the fact that I can't get through here. I get that. Okay, hey. How's it going today, man?
I've got to figure out how to get past this guy.
I can't just talk to you, right? Hey, buddy.
Help you, miss?
Yeah.
You gotta let me in. Check it. I'm totally legit.
Seems legit.
It's not a bad fake, kid.
Aww.
But you're in over your head here. Do yourself a favor and scram.
Yeah, figures. Okay, alrighty. No, pick it up. No shame. Keep your dignity. There we go. It's real. Gotta stick with the story. Gotta stick
Can't
with the lie.
Can't push me around. Should I go back and stand up to him?
No.
Or can something around here help me convince him?
I think I'm gonna see if I can distract him with the argument.
Those guys need to get a room.
Well, maybe they start fighting. The bouncer comes over here. He's not even saying anything. He's just smacking him and pointing at him.
Damn.
Mind your own business.
Okay. Try not to get involved here. I don't think I'll talk to him anymore. RV. Yes, how's the RV going today?
This RV's just begging for a little street art. But if I do it here, someone will see me.
Yeah, no shit, so let's not do anything. Like, what? Do you have a spray can in your pocket ready to go at all times for tagging? Fucking A. Like, how spontaneous do you have to be? Hey! Yeah! Graffiti! Okay, I know I was just bitching about it, but I mean, come on! What to draw? Am I gonna get to free candy! Free candy! Because it's funny! Oh, boy. Now watch somebody stick their head out the window. Recreational vandalism!
Free candy.
Free candy inside, gotta love it. That brings back a memory of an old photo. Like, that's a meme on the internet of one of those old brown vans with just free candy spray painted on the side, super shitty. Oh, that was one of my favorites. Okay, I think I'm gonna go to the machine. Oh, wait a minute. Okay, there's a let's just look at the bonfire real quick. What's S? Ponder.
Mom would totally flip her shit.
I remember this. You could just post up at random spots and hear errant thoughts.
This place is sketchy as hell. An old abandoned building in the middle of nowhere, miles from home.
Yeah, well, you were just standing on train tracks. I think this is the least of the dangerous situations of the day.
Now I remember why I'm here.
Any place is better than home. Well, not for everybody. All right, sometimes they end after a while. That was probably the last one. I'm just going to go ahead and get off of that. Dog kennel. Yeah, let's look at the dog kennel.
This place has collected a lot of junk over the years.
Yeah, is there anything behind here? Nope. Okay, motorcycles. Can I do anything with the bikes at all? Can only look at them.
I joined the motorcycle gang. If I had any friends.
Can I do anything with the machinery? I got to figure out how to get this guy to F off. I don't know how to do it.
That saw looks ancient. Okay. I wonder how long ago the mill actually closed.
That's where I came up from. There's gotta be something. Is it really the argument? Is it really the argument? I think it's the argument. Okay. Hey guys,
should probably avoid getting on that guy's shit list.
Okay, maybe it's not the argument. How the fuck do I get in here? Hey, gas can. Fuck yeah, pick it up.
Guess fire safety isn't exactly high on the agenda here.
Yeah, can we just start a massive fire and then use that as a distraction? Maybe, God, how do I... It's like panels over here. Oh, hey, what is this? What's this over here? Oh-ho!
This band shreds so hard. I gotta get in there.
Yeah, it looks like a door, Chloe. Fucking open it, walk through. Okay, I guess I can't, because I can't interact with the... What does second door is so close and yet so far?
So close and yet
it's not,
so far.
It's not locked though. You just unlatch it right there, slide it a little bit to the right, and you're done. Like that bingo bango bongo. Good to go. I don't know what to do. I don't know where to go. Hey, ignore me, okay? I'm just Hey, train car! Okay, can't really do anything with it though. Ah, god damn it. Okay, fine. I was trying to go by the train car, man. Asshole. I don't know. Look at the train. I like trains. Can I set a car alarm off or something like that back here? Come on, there's gotta be something I can do. There's gotta be something I can do!
Nothing says badass like a nice floral print.
Hmm. So I just had to look at the other bike. That wasn't with the other bikes. I didn't really realize that that was its own bike. Hey, buddy! I like the flowers! Yeah? Can I talk to you? Hey! Nice flowers!
Again? What do you want, kid?
Cool tribal armband. Which tribe are you from, Chad? Okay, let me inside now. The mill, your bike. I want to talk about your bike.
Is that your bike over there?
Yeah, is that your bike?
Yep.
It's, pretty cool.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. Like the flowers.
Thanks. Is that all?
The mill.
This is the old mill, right? I heard Firewalk is playing here tonight. They're awesome.
Yeah, they're awesome. Yeah.
Nope.
Nope? What?
Are you kidding?
You should probably just...
I recognize the music, you dimwit! Oh my god. Let me decide, dude. You started a backtalk challenge. Oh, snap! I feel like there should be some sort of music playing right now. Okay, let's see what this is then. Space to continue.
I have to convince this doorstop that I'm not giving up until he lets me inside.
Okay. In backtalk, you use arguments and insults to get someone to do what you want. Okay. That, okay. That's, I would imagine so.
Don't you remember what it's like to be a teenager? I just want to see the...
Okay,
band.
We're going with empathy.
I thought we went over this.
It's got a fucking score! Like, I see it now. To succeed, pay attention to what your opponent says. Bedtime. Okay. Your bedtime, no bedtime. Do me a solid, then pick a comeback that reflects their words back at them. Okay, okay. Alrighty. Your bedtime.
Oh, isn't it past yours?
Okay, I'm starting to see now. I'm starting to see.
But I still don't know you.
Of course you don't know me. Again, listen to your opponent's words. Alrighty, that's the word I was going with.
Look at my face. Do I look cute? Or do I look like I'm going to kick your ass?
Oh my god. That 0 to 10, man.
Okay, kid. I get it.
Yeah, you damn right I'm tough. I'm not a kid.
I am not a damn kid.
Yeah.
Other things I'm not. Young lady, kiddo, chica, sweet cakes.
She has connections with all those.
You? I can't protect you in there.
You can't protect... You can't... A girl like me!
You mean a girl...
I should have gone with the flowers on your bike. I should have gone with the flowers on the bike.
That kind of girl?
My boss will kill me if I let you.
I should have gone with the flowers. Who's your boss?
Is your boss your mom? Follow up. Do you live in your boss's basement?
Okay, so I'm starting to get a feel for what the statements are going to be like.
You're not accepting no for an answer.
No, I am not. You're going to have to let me in or I'm going to annoy you and not let you do your job for the rest of the night.
Yep.
What if I had a knife?
No problem.
A gun?
Don't care.
Don't care.
You could have a flamethrower, an army of robot ninjas, and a motherfucking dragon on a leash in there, and I'd still kick your
ass. Oh, snap!
I give up.
You're on your own with that one, Chloe. I think the ninjas would get me. I don't really feel confident against the ninjas. You do you. See you later. Holy shit. Okay, well, that's a new mechanic that's in this game then. You guys, I've been recording for a while already. It took me a while to figure that shit out. So that was a pleasant surprise to see that. I put a smile on my face. God. Dog. Barking at me. Really train your dog to not bark at the door. That's fucking creepy. Scream, don't touch my soul with dirty hint. It's gonna be just one of those dirty, graffitied, freaking writing on the walls. Everywhere. There's not even that many people here. What? Oh, that's because the concert's in the yep.
Can't wait to get in there and thrash.
Yeah, get in there and thrash. What's up, Frank? Actually, I kind of want to talk to Frank. Frank looks chill. Hey, what's up, Frank?
Yo, Frank.
What's up, Frank? Look chill.
Hey.
Chloe?
I know your name, you idiot. You bought pot for me every month for a
year. Yeah, pretty much.
Look at that getup. Studs, you're trying too hard.
No, I'm...
What are you even doing?
I'm not. It's because you're chill.
Firewalk, man. They rock.
Yeah, everybody's going fucking nuts in there.
How do you hear about this little shindig?
Ha, the internet. How else?
Yeah, that's...
Seriously? Fucking kids.
That's the best way to hear about it. How about some weed? Do you come here a lot?
So, you come here a lot, or...
Yeah.
All right, well, that's the end of that.
It's cool.
I'm really glad you approved.
Okay. Well, you don't get my business then. See you later.
Whatever.
I'm going to put weed in my pocket and get busted later or some shit like that. He, ladies and gentlemen, is from the first installment of Life is Strange. Not really a spoiler alert, but characters that get introduced, obviously Chloe's in the first Life is Strange as well. Characters that get introduced, I'll go ahead and just kind of point those things out. What the hell is this?
No thanks.
Oh!
I tried to avoid hepatitis.
Yeah, let's not recycle those. Okay, let's see here. Nudie? No. I'm not gonna look at that get demonetized. It's probably gonna go into high detail, 1080p resolution if I click on that look, but if it's just hanging out on the wall, it's like, It's like pastel or Picasso'd. Okay, saw blade, termination notice, drunk guy. Hey, drunk guy, how's it going?
Sweet dreams, hombre.
Hombre. Yeah, we should probably maybe roll him a little more onto his side. Nah, he'll be okay. All right, let's go ahead and you push, just push through.
Damn, there are a lot of people.
Yep, let's push through. Here we go. Yep, just oomph. Got it. Assert yourself. That's, you're fucked now. You're fucked now. Yep, you're done. Yep, uh-oh. Yep, mm-hmm. And that's a guy I think I wasn't supposed to get on the bad side of.
I'm fine.
Bumped into me, remember?
Uh-oh. Just say sorry.
Yep. My bad, dude.
You don't know who I am, dude.
No, first time here.
Don't care, either.
Ah, I wouldn't tack that on.
Hey, let me know how that works out for you.
Oh, shit.
Bitch.
Okay, well, he's letting us walk away, so he's probably not much.
Fine.
I'm not very afraid of him anymore.
Maybe I can get a better view of the action from up above.
Okay, I was thinking about going to the stairwell first, but, then I was like, I think I should just go to where the cutscene directed me. I get ahead of myself sometimes. Like, I always want to know the next step and cut a corner and get over there as quick as possible. And I thought that the stairs would be the end goal. So that's where I was just gonna go. And that's actually what I would do at a concert house, too. I'd take the fucking high ground and enjoy the concert.
Finally made it.
Nice. Up in the rafters. Sick. Grungy. Hopefully not copyrighted. Doubtful. The reverb's too heavy. Yeah, I was going to say, maybe don't hop around up there on the busted wood planks. She's on the most extreme one. Literally the next one to go. Space to leave. Can I just sit here and rock out for a while? That's literally all I'm going to do is just sit here and rock out for a while? I fucking love this game, man. This is when I would probably, pick up a snack or something like that. Or, take a drink of water and just enjoy it. I love these games, you guys. If you're watching, I appreciate you. I have the most fun on these. These are so much fun. Okay, alrighty. Yeah, the next song I don't like very much, so we're just going to go ahead and bounce out of here. Oh, it's going to be against my will. Okay. Yeah, I'm sorry about that. I don't understand why you're up here yelling at me.
You should be more careful. It's a rough place.
Yeah.
I don't like your attitude.
I don't like your... You! Okay, we're going to apologize.
I'm sorry about the beer, okay?
Not good enough.
Hey, I'm not doing anything else, man. I'm not doing anything else. Motherfucker, I'm just going to walk away. Not into him!
You're not done.
Walk to the back! Not to the hole, but to your... Okay, fine, fuck you.
Then how about I show you how unimpressed I am with limp dick assholes who get butt hurt over a spilled beer?
Oh, God. Oh, my God.
She's gonna regret every word. Every
word. Oh, snap.
Oh, this is gonna be...
Yeah, I'm pretty sure I'm just gonna throw you off of this,
I'm serious.
Off this ledge.
You wanna see me get angry here? Because I'm getting there. And it won't
just
be
push
pretty.
Him.
It won't.
Just push him, and then it's one-on-one. Oh, God, you should have pushed him.
Hey, dickhead.
Hey! I know you. Attack or run? This action will have consequences. Oh, fuck. Run. Oh, God! Cogged him right in the head! Hey, what's up, Rachel? You're looking better than ever.
Come on.
LOL.
Hurry up!
Alright, well, we're out of here, and Frank's trying to figure out what the fuck is going on. Hey, Frank, don't forget, I approve. Can you fuck those guys up for me? Thanks, buddy. See you later. I'll buy weed from you later. It's actually pretty good that I got... Oh, my God. The look on her face, dude. That was hilarious. And, of course, we went front row. Is it going to be another one of those sequences where it's just going to let us rock out until I'm done? I love this game, man. I never was a dancer in real life. I'll admit that much. I was always the guy on the stage playing the music people were dancing to. That's what I liked. Oh, that's not a third eye at all. Hi, Illuminati. It's got to be Chloe's room, right? I'd imagine so. I know, like, I already know what it looks like from, oh, that's funny, the middle finger. I think it is. Yeah, this is Chloe's room. From the previous game. Square Enix. One of their masterpieces, man. I love this game. Well, I don't know anything about this particular one, but the franchise. Life is Strange is fantastic. Rise and shine, Chloe! The world is waiting. Get out there and seize it. Carpe diem. Let's go. Deck 9. Come on, Chloe. Let's go. Let's go. No. No, that's not breakfast. Get downstairs. Make yourself an omelet. Get some bell peppers in there. Okay, fine. Nicotine, I guess. See, the risk of that is, like, how many times have you just rolled back over, closed your eyes, and went back to sleep? Life is Strange Before the Storm. Episode 1. Awake. It's a fitting title. Very nice point to just put it in. Right as she wakes up. All right, let's hop out of bed. Like I said, guys, carpe diem. Wake up, get the fuck up. That's what I think. I always liked that effect. The lo-fi, like, when it would cut down the radio.
All I want to do is shut my eyes and tell the world to go to hell.
Oh, look at the journal.
Daily rituals are important.
Max the loser. Yeah, that's right. I called you a loser.
One read letters to friends who have forgotten you.
Oh, wow. This is... Wow. I completely forgot. See, there was a diary journal thing in the other one, but it belonged to the main character of the other one. There's so much that I don't want to give away because I don't know where this particular story is going to go. But wow, like this is damn. This is going to be cool. This is going to be really cool. I just got incredibly excited.
Hey Max. Hey Dad. Another day in paradise, right?
Well, as crappy as it sounds, literally, so. Wakey, wakey, eggs and bakey. Make sure there's bell peppers in them.
Seeing Firewalk live. The skeevy assholes. That girl.
That girl. What, Rachel?
Was that really Rachel Amber?
Yeah, because you called her Rachel and she said... something it's which responded so to her name. I don't fucking remember what she said. Mr. Clothes. Sharky, how's it going today?
Fun fact. Shark babies eat their siblings in the womb. Maybe that's why I'm an only child.
Hey, I didn't know that. I'm going to have to put that for the fun fact of the day. I think I'll do that on this episode, actually. Oh, God, I got to remember now. Oh, shit. But maybe I need to make this the intro clip, too. Yeah, I think I'll do that. There we go. That's easy. Or maybe not. I don't know. Who's to say what happens in the rest of the episode? Where do I change my clothing? Drawer. There we go. Yeah, there we go. Get dressed. Beautiful. I was gonna say, like, I went to the closet, but it was only telling me to look at it. Forgot I have a what's it. Oh. Could I have picked what shirt? I think I could have picked what shirt. Can I change the shirt? Can I change my shirt? I have a feeling that this is like a GTA getting dressed thing. Oh, wait, what? Change, yeah! Oh my god, I just realized, like, there's, holy shit, you guys were probably screaming at me that whole time. Okay, Butterfly, Raven, oh, there's only two of them. I fucking love the Butterfly one, that's cool. That's really cool, yeah, let's go with the Butterfly. I was looking at the other two slots, trying to figure out if they were just plain Jane clothing, but I guess you can only load so many models. It looks like it's the same shirt though, just with a different texture on it. Eh, either way, customization, I'm not complaining. We'll go ahead and exit with this shirt. That is fantastical to me. Oh, how sassy! Did you see that?
I really should get going.
That's how you know you're about to go carpe diem the day. All right, let's get the hell out of here and go down and eat some eggs and bakey. Your phone.
It's not here. How drunk was I last night?
Pretty drunk. Yeah, I know. I heard it.
Try calling my phone with mom.
Oh, we're gonna have to be sneaky about it then. Ooh, we're gonna have to be sneaky so that she doesn't think that we lost our phone or whatever.
Okay. Mom's phone is probably in her room. I can use it to call mine, then figure out where the hell I left it.
Phone. Call. I remember that window that's right in front of me. Man, it is, like, this is bringing back memories from the other game.
How can Mom look at this every day and not see what a tool she's dating?
Oh my goodness, this brings back memories. How do I access my, contacts? Are you gonna do it? There we go. Okay, she's gonna complain a little bit more, and then she's gonna get it done. Ring ring! Might want to go in the room. Uh-oh. Where's that? Okay, just set that down. Sure, why not? Ring? What?
It sounds like my phone is definitely nearby. Mom's old
engagement. Oh, wait, what?
Supposed to be mine, if I'm ever stupid enough to get married.
Is it? Hang on. Oh. Yeah, there we go. Got it. Okay, beautiful. I was using my handy-dandy Turtle Beaches. Trying to pinpoint the location of that sound. Happy I found it. Looks like we missed a call, though. Oh, it's for me. How many times have you done that? Like, when you find your phone after calling it and you look at it and you're like, oh, I missed a call from who? Oh, yeah, that's right. That was like 30 seconds ago. Okay. Will you be coming home at some... Chloe will be there. We'll be... Oh, no. This is going to be fun when we go down there. Elliot, you finished the chem homework? No, dude, that's third time. I already know everything.
Hey, breakfast. Bring my purse down with you, please.
We're gonna get in trouble.
Yeah, okay.
All right, we need to go get her purse. It's probably in the room again.
I think I saw Mom's purse in her room.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. All right, let's see here. Drawer. What? Where is it? What? Hang on. Drawer. Let's open the drawer. Is it in the drawer? Kind of a weird place for a purse to be. Ew! Oh, God, close it! Ew! Oh, God, no! Ew, yuck. Okay, where the fuck is a purse, man? Like, I really don't see it. Am I that blind? Ring, look, take... Oh, there it is. Okay, yeah, got it. Bingo. Guess I was that blind.
Oh, can you grab my cell phone, too?
Yeah, sure. Let me just delete the last call that was made.
Yeah,
that really makes me want to hurry.
En route, ETA almost there. Left mouse button to go downstairs.
Coming, Mom.
Ah, it teleported me back to the top of the stairs. That's funny. Oh my God, it's so good to be back in the game, you guys. Like, this house and everything, everything is correlated to the last one.
You can put my purse on the dining table. Might still have time for breakfast if you hurry.
Dining table, here I come.
Can I get my breakfast first? Please? Okay, well, it's almost done. Put the purse down. Yep, there we go.
Chloe, I don't have all day. Would you get over here already?
It's kind of...
I should see what Mom wants before she strips.
I'm coming. What's up? What can I do for you?
Hey, Mom. You wanted to talk?
When I send you a text message, Chloe, like last night, I need you to answer.
You can just say text. You don't have to say message.
And I need you to answer without...
I was about to say, that's a snarky response. Sorry, I'll do better.
Sorry. I hear you. I'll do better about...
I'm not gonna lie and say I was sleeping.
Thank you.
Is that what you wanted to talk about?
Half.
What is it with you and David? Always cutting to the chase. Why can't we just have some pleasant conversation before school?
School.
Ah, right. School. My
favorite. Not gonna bitch about David. I didn't even know that was an option.
Yeah.
What to bitch about.
I used to think drugs were lame too.
I wish you wouldn't joke like that.
Okay, now back to David, alright.
You do realize I hate your boyfriend with every fiber of my being, right?
Wow!
Chloe! You don't hate him.
He calls me girly. He's a dickhole.
He can be old-fashioned.
Yeah, he can't. Yeah.
An old-fashioned dickhole.
Let's not fight. I made you breakfast.
Yeah, eggs and bacon, yeah. I know.
I'll just grab something later.
Oh, you'll enjoy this. The other day I made 4 eggs, 2 for David, 2 for me. And just before I served them, he says, "What are you gonna eat?"
That's funny.
I'll enjoy that, huh?
That's...
Tired, huh? That'll teach you to break.
Oh, snap!
What? I know what time you came home last night. And don't think you can get out of school just because you missed the bus again.
Why would you assume that...
Who do you think your principal calls when you skip?
You.
Do you think I enjoy lying for you, saying you're sick just so you don't get expelled?
No. But... you could keep doing it, that'd be great.
Between your grades and your disregard for my rules, I see you slipping. I'm worried.
But Mom, the whole point of lowering expectations is so you won't be disappointed in me.
Oh, God.
If you're happy doing what you're doing, fine. Keep at it. Just let me know so I can stop fighting with Blackwell to keep you on scholarship. Money's tight enough as it is.
Man, I don't even think that I had a period like that when I was her age. Maybe I just need to be left alone. Maybe David could help. Maybe that. The fuck is that? I'm gonna pick D, and I'm kind of nervous about it.
Maybe David should start paying rent.
Oh my God! Can we pick one option that's not laced with passive aggressive negativity? Holy fuck!
David thinks you need discipline.
David should mind his own business.
I think it's great David's taking an interest.
Okay, well, she's staying positive at least.
Maybe he can help.
I'd rather say my dad was a good guy than say David's an asshole.
Dad was a good man.
That's not fair. I'm glad your father still has a place in your heart.
Sorry, I had to say that, but I had to pick one of them.
Sometimes we need to make more room in our hearts for new people.
And sometimes, when we're incredibly desperate and lonely, we choose the absolute wrong kind of people to let into our hearts. Mom.
God, this is like...
David's had some hard times too, you know. If he's kind enough to share his experience, I expect you to listen.
Like I'd let him get within 15 feet
of me. Okay, hang on. I'm gonna pause for just a second here, you guys. And there's a reason for that. I need to play this game as if I'm not remembering or that I'm not... This is a prequel. I don't want to incorporate what's going on in the future, in the previous, you know, Life is Strange installment, into this. So, I think from here on out, I'm going to change my play style of it. I've only been going for a little while, like 30 minutes or something like that. I'm going to change my play style to reflect just basically what I feel Chloe would be feeling in the moment. I'm not going to let it hinder any of my choices, knowing what I know about the future. And I'm also trying not to give away too much, because I know that you guys will probably want to go check it out. So, with that being said, let's go ahead and jump back in.
When he takes you to school today.
Very funny.
You will be nice, you will be respectful, and you will say thank you.
Are you serious? This is such...
What, Chloe? Such what?
Mom's trying, I guess.
Yeah.
Maybe I should
too. Yeah.
But what's the point in getting along if it means pretending everything's fine when it's not?
It's because you gotta find what's fine about it. Say what you feel. No, fucking no. Because you... It's okay to feel things sometimes, you guys, and it's good to respond to the fact that you can't, like, you can control your feelings. Like, you can't just say you can't control your feelings, because you can. It's done through habit. It's not easy at first, but it's done through habit. So just simply going out and being, I don't know, man, we need to be understanding here. Even with what I just said, I'm gonna cut her a break, I'm gonna be understanding.
I know you're dealing with a lot.
Thank you. I understand you don't need me as much anymore. But I need
That's a really powerful statement.
I still need you. You're my mom.
I'm proud of you for being so self-sufficient.
Don't alienate her.
But the whole world's not out to get you.
Tell that to the world.
Yeah, well,
you're impossible. But I love you.
I love you too.
Mm-hmm. Okay, David's waiting. You'll need to bring him his keys from the ashtray.
Mm-mm.
Try not to kill each other.
Why are his keys in the ashtray?
Unless he tries to give me advice. or looks at me.
Okay, let's not give or ifs.
Looks at me at all.
Can we leave the buts out of this, please?
Mom.
Have a good day.
You too.
Even, like, Chloe's treating even her mom.
Keys is about the most humiliating thing Mom could ask me to do.
Why? Why is it so bad? Where's the ashtray? Trash? I don't even know where the fucking keys are. Where are the keys? Where do I go for the keys? Where's the... I don't even know why they're in the ashtray once again. Not the typical... Hey, there we go. Oh, they're in the ashtray
here
because he
are.
Doesn't smoke. It's not an ashtray. It's a key tray.
I made that for my mom.
I'm glad I accidentally looked at it one more time. That makes more sense now. I don't know why I thought he smoked. I don't know. I just
Let's
heard ashtray.
David so he can drive away.
U.S. Army, this will defend establishment.
No point in putting off the inevitable torture of driving to school with David. I better get going.
I forgot he was in the Army. That was one important part of his backstory. Hey, what's up? We got a text message. There we go. Hey, this is Chloe. This is Steph Gingrich. Hey, Steph. Have your DVD, you can get it before school. Thanks. Okay, so we gotta meet up with Steph before school then. Let's get the hell out of here, you guys. Go to school. Actually, kind of exciting. I've been to school in a while. Hey, there's a raven. I'm wearing a butterfly though. We gotta look for butterflies.
What a piece of crap. The car too.
Oh, you're so funny, Chloe. You're just so witty and negative all the time.
Take forever to get ready.
What the fuck do you use
We're
to cut your hair?
Men will leave without us.
How flat that is. Jeez. It's like his head is
no,
like that
Mom.
And it's a buzz cut.
I swear he beat himself to death with a tire iron. Repeatedly.
Oh yeah, self-inflicted beating wounds.
Electrode insulator's probably cracked. You know what a spark plug does?
Yes.
Yes.
It ignites.
Did you
the
not hear me? I said I know what it does.
Then go grab my socket wrench set from the garage, and we can get moving.
Okay. Yeah, I do know what a spark plug does.
What is this? Quality time?
Ugh. That's actually another thing that...
Better just get the socket.
Yeah, okay, Chloe. That's another thing that people do sometimes that, like, is a habit that you can fall into.
What's David doing? Leaving stuff in our garage anyway?
He'll ask a question.
Does he think he's moving in?
And you know, somebody will say yes, and then you'll answer as if they said no. It's, I don't know. It's, people are weird, man. Like, and I mean people in general. People's habits that we can form. The overarching OCD of the human race is just very interesting. Okay, we need the socket set, so I'm assuming it might be in here, possibly. They're usually in a tiny little suitcase looking thing. Yep, there it is. Just a tiny socket set. There we go.
50-50 chance I smash him in the face with this.
It's not that...
64.
It's not...
Maybe 90.
Okay, let's go for the 10 then. Because it's not gonna do the trick. It's just gonna, like, kind of maybe leave a bruise. Maybe. Okay, here we go. Socket wrench. There you go.
A little more hustle wouldn't have killed
What? Me. I held shift? You dick. Think I did. I don't think I did, actually, now that I think about it. Yeah, you're right. I probably could have ran over there. The whole 10 fucking feet right up the driveway. I could have ran. Add some hustle.
See what's gunking up the works there? That's a sign of
carbon deposits. No shit.
Oh, I think I have those in my engine right now.
Actually be good at this. If you lost the attitude.
My attitude is what makes me special.
No, it's not.
All right.
Not at all. It's the fact that you can be good at that is the thing that makes you special. Be kind while you're doing it, and you'll make a lot more friends. I'm very negative about negative people. It's the one time I'm, like, consistently negative. I've noticed that in my life. Can we... Oh, yes! Accept the fist bump. Yeah.
Fine.
Fuck yeah.
Whatever.
Fist bump ya. Boop. There we go. Fist bump. Not really touching tips. It's more like touching nubs.
Hey, you're taking those tools with you, right?
Every house needs a good toolbox.
What?
We've already got one, but thanks.
Well, that's a big one. And it's probably got more tools in. Yeah, look at that tiny little thing. Look at that. Like, literally, if you had a nice toolbox in every house in America, you'd be fucking surprised at how many things would... Well, actually, no. People probably wouldn't even use it.
Please don't want to.
But if you took the time to use it, there's so many things that you can fix with just a toolbox.
We don't have to like each other, but you will respect me. You've enjoyed enough of a vacation from having a father figure. So there's some things I want to be real clear about.
Okay. Ignore and endure.
Joyce, your mother, she's hurting, Chloe. Hurting for you. You've had it rough, no doubt about it. But all this staying out late, ignoring her command, drinking, drug use, it's making everything harder for her. You need to shape up, get your act together, and put someone else first for a damn change.
Yeah, well, everything else.
Am I making myself clear?
Yeah.
Is it crazy if part of what David's saying makes
exactly
sense to me?
And that's the thing, is that regardless of whether you want to hear it or not, that's the goddamn truth. Got it.
Got it. Thanks. We should really get
the only
going.
Thing I don't agree with is putting somebody else first.
Glad we understand each other.
Like, always put yourself first. Always. Because you're the most dependable person in your life. You're the only one that you can really depend on. Put yourself first, but don't do it in a selfish way. Do it in a way that encourages growth and encourages you to be good for the people around you. That way, being selfish
country
is being selfless in a way.
You're sick.
Hopefully not copyrighted once again.
I love this song.
Yeah, we're in a different thing right now, and you're wearing a different shirt and stuff. I love the dream sequences. Yeah. I love doing that, hanging my hand out a car window, making it go up and down.
What a beautiful day.
Socket wrench. Look at the purse. Yeah, look at the purse.
I guess Mom left her purse back here.
Talking to him will be the last thing I think I should do, because I think that's going to be what breaks the dream.
Spark plug does.
Jerkwad. I need to remember that one.
If Mom were here, she'd tell him to turn that junk off.
Talk to him. Break the illusion.
Dad, turn it up.
It didn't. It didn't break it. Gotta love it. Uh-oh. I didn't think that was going to be what it was. I didn't say that earlier. I hinted at it, but her dad was obviously killed in a car accident when they were younger. I can't remember exactly what the age was, but that's just one of the overarching themes that you know from pretty much the beginning.
Hey.
The hell?
Out of the car, Chloe. You're going to be late.
And I think it's that Clorox sock comparison, if you guys know what I'm talking about. I'll thank him.
Shit. Thanks.
Don't use that sarcastic tone with me, young
I was...
I can see you.
I fucking said thank you!
I was actually saying
thank you. I see everything.
I would pick thank you to say thank you!
I'll warn everything.
Asshole. The fuck? I said thank you to say thank you. That's what the word thank you is for. There's two words there, actually. It's
hello,
a phrase.
BlacKHaLLoW.
Hey! It's Blackwell. I mean, it's Blackwell. But it's kind of close to BlacKHaLLoW. You know, I was like 60% in Life is Strange. They said like 60% of my name. Yep. That's right, guys. That was me. Ish. Future needs excellence. Jeremiah Blackwell. Oh my goodness. It's so good to be back on campus. Brings back memories of the last game. I wonder what's going on with the stage. Remember the flag. Okay, I was gonna say, like, when's the stock footage gonna end? Just like random
hey,
pans with
Chloe.
Depth of field.
Oh. Hey, Elliot.
Hey there.
I heard you had a hell of a night. I mean, people are talking
about. Oh yeah, the crazy time.
Who exactly is talking shit about me?
You know, haters. on social media.
Great. I wish I could tell everyone to just get a life.
That's why I don't like social media.
How about The Tempest? Blackwell Theater at its most pretentious.
Personal social media, yeah, I should say.
Totally.
I love the BlackHaLLoW stuff. Like, everything I do with you guys is fucking awesome.
Thinking,
but I don't like getting on my own Facebook anymore. Tomorrow? Oh, God. I didn't hear the question. Those are two very... Maybe? Okay, that'd be what I'd answer in real life.
I try to make it a rule not to go to school any more than I have to. But sitting in the back row and making fun of the drama kids might not suck.
Right? Oh, it's drama!
That's
okay.
Totally what I was
I don't want to make fun of them. I was a drama kid. Kinda.
See you in chem.
Yeah, for sure.
I was more of a music guy, but... Actually, drama came more after high school, I would say. Press and hold, view your objective, which I already know.
I've still got time before class.
Alright, get the DVD from Steph. I think she's gonna be in the same outfit always. Wait, what? No. God, okay, fucking, I clicked off the phone. There we go. Max, Steph, there we go, Steph. At the picnic tables with Mikey, thanks, on my way. Okay, at the picnic tables. Picnic tables, there we go. Got him, that's right. I forgot. And I actually think that the last time I was at these picnic tables, I was talking to Mikey too. Holy crap, you guys. Like, they brought everything back. This is such a trip. Steph and Mikey. Hey, how's it going, guys? What up?
If I had known the Celestial Avenger was bloodied, I would have totally given him my potion.
It was a skill challenge. Potion wouldn't have worked.
Skill challenge?
It's part of the tabletop game we play.
You wouldn't understand.
Try me.
Give me a break, nerds. I've heard of tabletop games.
Yeah, let's see what I can do.
Cool. Now that is a creature I wouldn't want to fight.
Oh, yeah? Why is that?
Got my DVD.
One Blade Runner. Director's cut coming right
nice.
Up.
Nice.
Sweet. $5, right?
Keep it.
Wait a minute.
I'm just glad someone here appreciates the classics. You even asked for the director's cut, which took out the shitty voiceover and replaced it with a sweet dream sequence.
They're, like, actually talking about the...
That's my motto.
Wow.
Right on.
It's always weird when video games have a gray line between referencing real life, you know?
Rachel Amber? You're asking me?
Yeah.
Didn't you two go out last night, or was it just, like, a friend thing?
We met up at the... We're not friend... What's it to... Oh, God. Why... Can I have a third option that just says something else? I don't care what. Be potatoes for all I care. What's it to you? We're not friends. I don't want to be rude, but if I say we're not friends, he's like awkward. He's like, I should say something. I think the group is depending on me to say something right now. It's super awkward. Okay, we're not friends.
I don't know what you heard, but Rachel and I barely know each other.
Oh, sweet.
Yeah.
Steph has a crush.
Ah. Well.
Chloe, you should join
our
team.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure that that's the truth, that they barely know each other.
Thanks, though.
We're at the end of the campaign, so it'll only take, like, 20 minutes? What else have you got to do before class?
You know what? Sure. Let's do it. No! I'm fat!
Maybe later.
I'm sorry.
You know where to find us.
I'm sorry. Wait, can I just... Hang on. Wait.
DVD?
Wait.
Check. Next stop... Chemistry class.
Wait, can I?
Joy.
Can I play with you guys?
Ready to begin your adventure?
Yeah, fuck yeah, I'm ready to
just
play. Game within a game!
Mikey was about to seriously die a horrible and painful death.
Yeah, let's do it. Not fat fingering it this time.
Game on, nerds.
Alright, let's see what this game is.
Here's a character sheet. You are an elf barbarian.
Okay, I'm an elf barbarian. I'm totally an elf barbarian.
Nice. I could totally see myself as an elf barbarian.
I know. I'm good. All right, let's get started. You are both famous heroes.
It's like Dungeons and Dragons.
Kingdom of Avernon, a once peaceful land, now laid to waste by the bloodthirsty raiders of the Black.
Ooh.
Alone, you have fought your way through the raider camps, seeking their warlord leader, Durgaron, the Unspoken.
You should be a fucking playwright.
As you enter the final camp, bloodied and weary, you see your fellow hero approaching from the opposite direction.
Uh-huh.
I raise my staff to you in greeting.
Salutations!
I am Elima, wizard of the Third Circle, foremost advisor to King Tiberius, and sworn defender.
Cool! I'm an elf barbarian!
introduce your character.
I'm an elf barbarian.
Yeah, okay. I'm an elf barbarian named...
Barb.
Barb.
No. Steph.
Hey, give Barb a chance.
Exactly. Okay? I know what I said. I said Barb.
The two heroes.
Hold on. Elamon narrows his eyes at the elf in front of him and says, I am here to defeat Durgaron, the Unscarred. In the name of King Tiberius, what makes you think you are worthy to fight alongside me?
I once made a man kebab, according to my character sheet.
It says right here that I taught your precious King Tiberius everything he knows about fighting. So, Elamon, what makes you think you are worthy to fight alongside me?
Oh, snap!
You gave her that elf barbarian.
That elf barbarian.
Elamon bows deeply. I've heard of you in the castle. King Tiberius owes you his life.
Bitch.
It's an honor to fight alongside.
Damn right. Who said you were fighting alongside me? Step aside. Go get me my Gatorade. Water boy.
To your left, the raiders' training ground. To your right, their prison camp. Straight ahead, an enormous, ostentatious tent that could only belong to Durgaron, the Unscarred.
Ooh.
Which way do you go?
Straight ahead, right? We're supposed to kill the dude.
Elamon frowns. The raiders could have some good loot at the training ground, and surely it is our duty to free all those prisoners.
Ah, that is true.
Your choice, newbie.
But we're supposed to kill the dude.
Where do you wish to go?
We have to kill the dude. I'm pretty sure we have to kill the dude. We're gonna go to the, We're gonna go to the training ground, I think, and loot it. No, we're gonna go to the prison camp and free him.
Guess it's time to free some peeps. Let's go to the prison
Why?
Camp.
Because I feel like this is gonna be a recurring scene where I can continue to progress the game.
Cages, each imprisoning a human villager, calling out for you to free them. Only a small, elderly dragonkin is keeping watch. He notices you, and in terror,
Boo.
Runs into one of the few empty cages and locks himself
in.
Oh,
wow. Poor little exactly.
Dragon. What's a dragonkin?
Dragonkin are Brady like cat. Little dragon people. They're assholes. I bet he has all the keys.
Okay. Hey, shitface! Get out of there!
The dragonkin hops up and down, shaking his ring of keys at you. He shouts in a strange language. Whatever he's saying probably isn't for
I can imagine
Got
so.
Any useful spells in that robe of yours?
Nothing that wouldn't blow up the cage and everything.
Including
in
the keys. Tempt with bread.
Apparently, I have bread. I try to tempt the little bastard out.
Yeah, it's sourdough.
He sticks out his tongue, finding your offering disgusting.
Oh, well, fine then. We'll go ahead and pick the lock then.
Says here I can pick locks. Can I do that?
Sure.
Hey.
You spent a long time trying to pick the lock, but don't accomplish anything.
Aw, shit.
The dragonkin makes an obscene gesture at what you can only assume are his genitals. Shit.
LOL.
That's funny. He just said LOL. It's not funny anymore.
That's a skill I have. Can I do that? I want the little bastard to shit his pants.
You can try.
All right.
What do you say?
Listen up. You little lizard.
Unfortunately, he doesn't speak common, which means he can't.
I cast communication on the dragon.
Hey.
Shit. Really?
There we go.
Now he can understand every word you say.
Oh, snap.
Time to work some real
magic. Here we go.
So this is called a skill challenge, where you try to use.
Oh, I know what this is. I grab the bars of the cage and lean in.
Nice and close.
He steps back. His scaly skin quivering in fear. What do you say?
Meat puppet.
I wiggle my hand. Hey, dragonkin guy. Want to become my meat puppet? How it works is I shove my arm up your ass into your head, and then I can control your mouth from the inside to say things.
I don't think that's anatomically possible.
He doesn't seem to like that idea.
Okay.
Neither do
I. Okay.
The dragonkin pleads with you. Please don't harm me, tall one. But I cannot give you key. Durgaron, much taller and meaner than you.
Okay. Hey. Should I threaten him? Yeah, I'm gonna make you shorter.
You're short, I say. But you can always get shorter. Give me the key,
or I'll chop off your legs and beat you to death
with
them.
Oh, God.
The dragon can cower.
I'm getting kind of hostile here.
Left and right. He opens his jaws, and you think he's about to yell for help.
Uh-huh.
I interrupt his yell by shoving my axe into the cage, pinning his head to the bars without hurting him. Then I say the following.
This is going to be
good. Oh, here we go.
Here's what's up. I'm going to carve the skin from your bones. Then I'm going to turn your skin into a little leather handbag that I'll shove your skinless body into so I can carry it around.
She's like her face.
That
way, look at her face when it goes back to this.
Asshat refuses to give me a key I want. I can pull your body out and show them what happens. How does that sound?
Oh my God. Look at her face.
Wow.
Yeah.
That was
nice. Did I get the key?
I'm going to give you a +10 bonus to charisma. Go ahead and roll.
Is that good?
A small pool of urine collects under the elderly dragonkin as, hands trembling, it hands you the key. Then it dies of
fear. Oh, I feel bad. Yeah. It died.
Why don't you start unlocking the prisoners?
I'm on.
Yeah, boy.
As you free them, the prisoners run away from you in fear.
Oh, shit.
What's next?
I think we're gonna have to save it for next time, you guys. I've got some chemistry class.
Yeah, I'm done
what?
Here. Peace.
What?
Really? We were just getting to the good stuff.
If you go now, you can't rejoin.
Oh, no, 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 I'm staying then. Oh, I'm staying. I'll stay. I'm gonna stay.
Alright, fine.
Oh, I wanna do this. I wanna do this whole thing. This is gonna add like an extra 30 minutes to the episode, but I'm totally chill with it.
Loot sounds good. Let's go to the training
ground. Yeah, we'll kill him last. Sweet. We'll let him watch his whole entire kingdom crumble below him.
You are spotted by a heavy set.
Oh, heavy set.
Immediately shouts,
he prefers husky.
There are a dozen raiders on the training
field, mm-hmm.
all of whom raise their weapons and charge.
Mm.
Okay. So what do?
I cast Urgul's acid blast.
Overkill?
Bam!
You conjure up a wave of acid that washes over the charging orcs. Every raider suddenly starts screaming and writhing in pain. There's a sweet and sour kind of flesh melts off their bones like warm candle wax.
Like warm candle wax.
You see why I haven't really needed a partner?
A heavy-set orc sergeant still remains. He runs at you, swinging a massive warhammer.
All yours.
All mine. All right, well, I think I'm going to have to do a fatal cleave.
Okay, let's end this. Fatal
because it's fatal.
You swing your great axe downward with both hands. The orc blinks, then splits open like a hot dog bun.
Oh!
Yeah! I'm awesome at
I'm
this
awesome
game.
I'm awesome at this game.
It's going well.
Alright.
What about the
loot?
Yeah,
what about the loot?
Well, as the training ground is now a roiling pit of acid, it's unlikely
any dang. We all make mistakes.
Don't worry, Alamon guy. We all make mistakes.
Elamon nods.
Haha.
Barb, the elf barbarian, is most wise and forgiving.
Gotta be forgiving, yo. Warlord's tent. Let's go kill the dude.
It's tent time.
This is fun. I'm glad I did this, man.
Warlord of the Raiders of the Black Well, sitting comfortably at his throne. He's a huge red-eyed minotaur.
Oh, that's so badass. Let's gut him.
A two-handed sword that's easily 6 feet long. His laughter bellows. Your lands and people are already mine. Your deeds here mean nothing. Your kingdom was weak. You are weak.
What an asshole.
Yeah,
I got this. I cast Zael's cataclysmic cone of fire.
Oh, snap.
The fire fizzles out on contact. Durgaron laughs again, holding up his right arm to show off his bracer of fire immunity. Shit.
All of my battle spells are fire.
Okay,
based.
Fatal cleave
except
time.
Or, you know, acid blast, which someone used unnecessarily to show off.
Oh no!
What'll it be?
Annihilation strike sounds best. Wrathful rush. I don't really want to rush him. He's pretty big and I could be quick, but annihilation strike, yep.
Oh, holy shit! Annihilation strike. That sounds boss as
yeah, that
fuck.
Sounds pretty good.
One
uh-oh.
That's bad,
that's
right?
Really bad.
Not for me.
Uh-oh.
As you take your first step, you trip on a rock, collapsing onto the ground in a clangy jumble of metal. Your axe swings wildly to the side. Mikey, roll a reflex save.
Here we go. You better not fuck this up, Mikey.
God.
Your axe strikes Elamon's leg.
Legs?
Legs. Plural. Severing both feet at the
ankles.
We're
fucking everything up! I'm so sorry!
I am so sorry.
Durgaron moves toward the crippled Elmon.
Oh, shit!
And I told you this was my best boss.
Oh, no!
You didn't tell me my character might
Oh,
die.
No!
Durgaron approaches, stomping his bloody hooves. Stomp. Stomp. Stomp.
Yeah.
This is all my fault. Sort of. What
should I
do?
I don't know. Jump in front of Elamon, dance, encourage, jump in front of Elamon.
I jump in front of Elamon.
Wow. Thanks, Chloe.
Yeah, I don't want your character to die. I mean, I don't think this is gonna...
Thanks,
yeah,
Barb.
You fucking right, Barb.
Okay. Durgaron has now turned his attention toward you.
Bring it.
He charges, thrusting madly with his great
Giggity.
Sword.
What did I roll?
No.
A one?
Your attempt to dodge his thrust fails.
Uh-oh.
Durgaron laughs as he impales you on his blade,
lifting
you high into the air. Seriously?
I can't do anything with that stupid bracelet. I'm sorry.
I'm dead. It's okay.
Hey, I chopped your feet off.
Yeah, you're probably going to die there anyway, so.
Draining away as Durgaron lifts you higher into the air. It hurts like hell.
Hmm?
What do you do?
I swing for his head, I don't know, I swing for his arm and might sever the arm and swing for his head.
I take one last swing at
Dirtface's
head.
Head.
You have to roll high to hit. You're almost dead.
Let's do this,
oh, no.
Boys.
11. You swing, catching Durgaron on the side of his head, severing one horn. But you don't do enough damage.
I should have severed his arm. I should have severed the arm.
He laughs. Then rips you off his sword with a vicious jerk. You die painfully.
Oh.
So
I'm sorry, Chloe. I have to.
That's okay. I'm dead.
Hey, man. If you can.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Get the fuck
I
out of there.
Warden's hideaway.
You sure?
It's all I've got.
You summon a spectral door, which shields you from Durgaron. Light flares out, blinding him. The door swings shut, then disappears. You are gone from sight. And cannot be home.
Damn.
I guess I'll have to come back when I'm stronger.
Mm-hmm. And you have feet.
That was fun.
Check out what I drew.
What'd you draw? Wow, that whole time?
Mikey's got serious drawing skills.
Nice! We wouldn't have ever seen that if we didn't play this game.
Sorry I died and left you out there to fend for yourself.
Yeah, my bad.
It's cool. I'll get him. Eventually.
Hopefully.
Glad you enjoyed it,
Chloe. It was a good time.
Yeah. I'll adventure with you anytime.
I think I'm going to do this every single episode, you guys. If there are more,
thanks for the game.
I'm totally going to do that. That was a lot of fun. And keep in mind that that is completely non-required. We're going back to the main story right now. Like, oh my god, that was a blast. I'm so happy I did that. I'm so happy. Hopefully, you guys, if you didn't want to see it, you fast-forwarded and you found a way to get around it. But I really wanted to do that. I really wanted to do that, and I had a blast doing it. What's going on here?
Uh-oh.
Awkward.
What have you got here? Twitch? Don't call me that.
Finder.
North. A jock so dumb he makes jocks look bad. Guess Nathan Prescott made the shit list.
Oh, that's Nathan.
Oh, wow. This is some really weird crap, Prescott. It's not yours. Give it back. I hate that you're on the team now. You're such a loser.
People aren't very nice. Take it elsewhere, take it elsewhere, guys.
Wanna take this elsewhere,
yeah, come
guys?
On.
The mute speaks?
The mute speaks? You wanna hear what else I have to say?
Whoa! You earn a spot on the squad, Twitch. You don't have your dad try to buy off the coach.
At least my family pays for
it. Oh, no!
How much financially does your deadbeat dad need
again? No, you're gonna die now.
Wow. Dick.
Just turn around, walk in the doors.
My dad lost his job at the shipyard. When your dad closed it down, and you want to talk shit to me?
Leave Nathan alone.
Leave Brittany alone.
You know something, Prescott? I'm going to do you a favor. You can't be a part of the team and be into this stupid crap at the same time.
Hey, I like photography, or he likes photography. Oh, no.
You're a piece of shit. I am going
Stop
to
it.
Kill If you deserved you. To be on the team, you'd be able to catch it before it went into the water. I'm just saying that.
Do something. Don't just stand there
He
watching.
Would have thrown it in by now. Stay out, yeah, and step in.
The only way to stop a bully is to be aggressive. I've got to put Drew
down. Not really.
Back off.
But I'll do it in this case. There's hella lot more ways to deal with a bully. What the hell did I just say? Idiot?
Idiot? You're not used to a word that big, are you? Don't be scared.
You're seriously defending Nathan?
Defending is art, dude. Got me feeling sorry for Prescott. Nathan's an easy target.
How about picking on someone your own size? Which I hear is pretty small.
You're such a crazy freak. Mind your own business.
No. I'm crazy, that's true. But you know what's crazy?
What's crazy is that you haven't been held back yet. How is that possible?
Oh, snap.
You want a piece of this?
Oh, snap, you're gonna hit a girl. Oh, snap, we're just having a verbal argument. Piece of cake.
Please. Kicking your ass is going to be a piece
of let's not actually make threats here, Chloe.
Did you just laugh?
Of course she did.
I did. Chloe just owned me.
Bitch.
Shut the fuck up, fresh meat.
Oh, snap.
Go Samantha.
Did you just give his portfolio back, dude? Just give it back.
Guess you got lucky this time, Prescott. Had two girls show up to save you. Take your pervy picture.
It's portfolio.
Are you okay?
You think I need help? From
hey,
you?
Fuck you, green eyes.
You're welcome.
Are you all
asshole?
Thanks for sticking up for him.
Secure.
People think just because of his family.
Hey there.
Everything okay?
Ah, yeah, it's great.
No problems.
10 out of 10. Verbal jujitsu. He walks like he has back problems. Oh my god, that was fun. I love that new mechanic. Glad we talked. Me too. I know you're doing your best. I love you. I think David probably talked to her. We've got to do our best. Like, that's what it boils down to. Alright, let's enter. Get this show on the- Oh. Hello.
Oh, good.
You're good. Here I am. What kind of... What? Oh my god, am I getting... Is this going to be a drama thing? She was wearing a costume. I fucking knew it.
I do beseech you, chiefly that I might set it in my prayers. What is your name?
Miranda. Oh, my father. I have broke your hest to say so.
Good. Admired Miranda. Indeed worth what's dearest in the world. Many a lady I have eyed with best regard, and many a time had listened to... The harmony of their tongues...
You're killing me. You've had weeks to be
You fucked up.
Sorry, Mr. Keith.
Yeah.
No, don't apologize to me. Apologize to your scene partner, who's been very accommodating, and to your other fellow actors, and most of all, to yourself.
I volunteer as tribute...
Keaton. Sorry to interrupt, but does this look better? I had my mom take it in a bit.
Rachel looks awesome.
Oh, that is Rachel. Okay. Her hair looks... She fucking winked!
As last night.
Looking good,
Rachel. Hey, back
Very
off!
Cool. Exquisite Rachel, as always.
Mr. Keaton, I'm still having trouble with... My affections are then most humble. I have no ambition to see a goodlier man. I mean, does she really mean that?
Especially because I just straight out told her I've been banging all the
ladies.
Yeah, that is hard. We've talked about that line forever. We need a fresh perspective.
Oh. Okay. I don't have expertise in this.
Are Miranda's feelings of instant passion for Ferdinand just inexperience in dramatic circumstances, or has she actually just met the love of her life? What do you think?
I see what you're saying. It's true love.
Sometimes, when you meet someone who's going to change your life, you just know it, I guess. Also, you've got parents coming to see the show, right? At $20 a ticket, it's gotta be true.
Wow. A romantic and
that's funny.
That actually kinda helps me. Thanks.
Damn.
Thanks, Mr. Keaton.
Later.
See you later, guys.
Bye-bye!
Oh, no. I have first period improv with a class full of freshmen now.
Gotta love it. Improv with freshmen. At least you have them all in one group and not, like, cluttering up the other ones. Hey, yeah, that's
I'll
right.
Just be a
I was flirting with you for a second
okay.
there.
Okay. So, why am I here?
Probably to add that opinion,
oh,
and then...
Oh, can you grab my belt for me? I think it's in my bag over there. Yeah. Sure.
Asking a favor already. Alrighty.
Okay. Get the belt. Don't say any stupid shit, and don't...
I thought she'd continue the dialogue. I was even, like, not talking over her so I could listen to it. Damn, I'm sorry. No, you don't need to rifle through the... get the
big... Rachel looks so happy here.
The belt in the bag. There we go. I was gonna say, please don't pull anything else out, because then that's just making it creepy.
Guess I'll go give this to Rachel.
Yeah, what's that noise? Is that a bell or something? Rachel! Rachel! You're behind the thing, aren't you?
Rachel? Is this your belt?
Yes! Thank you.
Bring it to her or throw it over? Oh, God. I'm gonna bring it to her. I mean, might as well. Here you go. Got your belt. That was a cool costume.
I really liked your costume.
Thanks.
The way she turned around, the way they animated her like that.
Flowers for my dressing room.
Kind of made it almost like panic me a little bit. I'll owe you just the. I'll owe you.
I guess I owe you.
I'll hold you to that.
You do always have to bring flowers. That's a that's like, yeah.
I'll let you finish changing now.
If I had a dollar for every time I brought flowers to opening night, I'd probably have all the money to pay back several of those bouquets.
Chloe Price.
Rachel Amber.
Last night was amazing.
Yeah. Yeah, getting attacked was amazing. No, I'm kidding.
You call getting attacked by humans amazing? I've got to hang out with you more.
Deal.
Oh!
To tell the truth...
So it ended up going well.
I went to bed last night wishing it never had to end.
Really?
But then I thought, why? Why does it have to end?
Hey. Maybe it doesn't.
Maybe it doesn't have to...
You didn't have to say the last part.
Exactly.
Stutter.
How would you like to join me... on a little field trip.
Has Rachel Amber gone rogue?
Ditch class. You mean it?
Is that weird?
No.
No, it's awesome.
It's not weird, it's just in moderation.
Let's get the hell
and
out
And also
here.
Heavily frowned upon, so like, probably never, but I mean, kids are gonna be kids, I did it. Oh my God, man. This is awesome, I'm really enjoying the hell out of this one. I don't even know how long the episode is, to be honest with you guys. I mean, you can look at the, you know, the thing on YouTube and see how long is left, but...
You sure you don't want to just grab the bus, or...?
Nope. If we're gonna go rogue, we're doing it right.
Alright, I trust you.
Well,
what?
What the hell am I getting into here?
I'm not sure, actually. Okay, we're getting on a train. And we're going train. Okay. All right. That works for me.
Where does this thing?
I don't know.
North? Maybe we'll end up in.
Holy crap, Rachel! Are we just going for it?
Pull up a chair, Price. The view's amazing.
It is. I bet it smells incredible too. Elliot.
Rachel.
Oh God, it fucking skipped another one. Hey, why weren't you in chem? Everything okay? Yeah, everything's great. Yeah. What happened with Drew? People saying you were awesome. Yo, let's talk later. Okay. Yeah, it was a whole thing.
Who wants me to pull up a chair? Maybe one of these.
Yeah, kids. There we go. Move this guy. Perfect. That would actually be a hell of a lot of fun. There's a guy that I watch on YouTube. I think his name's like Shy.
Heavier than it looks.
Think it's Shy, I think.
Guess I should sit down.
I can't remember, but he does crazy shit like hopping trains and trespassing and going into factories and stuff like that, parkouring and
Amber.
Watching him go down on a on a train one time was really cool. So
is this nervousness? Is that what this feeling is? Wish Max were here.
You know, that's the thing though, is that it's okay to have that silence.
Should I make small talk? Is that what people do?
The way she's looking at her is like, that's so funny. Say nothing. You know what? I don't need to say anything. And see, that's the thing, is that you should be able to hang out with people that you don't need to say anything to. I'm sure she's probably going to say something.
So, it's kind of weird that we're hanging out.
That's probably what she would have said if
maybe
I said,
I don't hang out with anyone and I don't have any friends.
You have friends.
Well, I used to. Friend. Singular. Her name was Max, but she left for greener, more northern pastures. Mm-hmm.
That sucks.
Yeah. Shit, Mr. Key. Say thanks.
Hey, so.
Yeah, for saving my ass.
For pulling you.
No, for saving my ass.
No, dummy. Thanks for last night.
Yeah, I had a feeling that's what the thanks was for, so.
If you hadn't shown up.
Assholes abound in Arcadia Bay.
You handled them pretty well.
That's for sure.
Is that why you came along?
Are you suggesting I should need a reason to ditch school?
I bet you're wondering what we're doing.
We're on...
The thought occurred.
Yeah.
Well... I wanted some company.
Okay.
That's it?
That's it.
I love company.
Good to fucking go. Anything beats another second in Blackwell.
You really hate it there, don't you?
You don't? Right. What reason would Rachel Amber have for hating Blackwell Academy? Your high school
royalty. You don't need to be a cynic to her. Yeah, I was gonna say.
Yet.
Hey.
Let's do something fun.
You never need to judge someone you're on the fast track of getting to know. You'll find out in time. Agree or flirt? Yeah, I'll flirt.
V-card's been punched, Rachel. I'm sorry.
Wow.
Okay, well, fine then.
Well, I don't know.
Well, I didn't think that she was going to say...
Okay,
simple. That's not flirting to me.
Two truths.
Flirting is throwing eyes.
What?
Not literally.
We should play Two Truths and a Lie. It's a game where each person offers up three facts about themselves, two of which are the truth, and one of which is...
A lie.
A lie.
Right. And then the other person has to guess which is which.
Okay. Sounds fun. I can do that.
Sounds fun.
Yeah. The way that her body language came up, like, and the way that she sat down, too, that was, like...
I'll start. First, I'm ambidextrous.
That was part of the reason why I went with the flirt, but I didn't realize.
Second, I was born in New York, the land of fashion and
Broadway. Okay.
To which I will one day return when my heinous exile here in Arcadia Bay comes to
Okay.
New York, huh? I've never been.
Not a world traveler?
No.
Not yet, at least.
If you could travel anywhere, where would you go? Russia, Greece?
Greece would be a lot of fun. Greece would be a lot of fun.
Kathmandu
would be fun too, but Greece.
One day, I'm going to climb.
That's actually on my bucket list.
And I thought moving away from Arcadia Bay was ambitious. What's your third thing?
My third thing?
Two truths and a lie. You say three things.
Right. I'm a Leo.
Okay. Well, we've got the three.
Okay. So, ambidextrous. Born in New York, and a Leo.
Gotcha.
So, which is the lie?
She doesn't strike me as a Leo. She strikes me as, like, Aquarius Leo.
You're way too lucky to be a Leo. You've got to be a Sagittarius
or
something. The Archer? That'd be cool. Like, Artemis? but
seriously? I thought you were an Aquarius.
Seriously? Hear me roar.
Oh, okay.
No, the lie was near.
Really?
I've never been there, though I want to one day. I was born in Long Beach.
Okay, I can see the Long Beach now.
You're on the bucket list, man. Sounds good.
Okay, your turn, Frank.
All right. This thing looks like she's getting close to me.
Right. Something about myself. Should I start things off with a lie or with the truth? Or should I cheat?
Should you cheat?
Let's see how good she really is at this game.
I'll start off with the lie. I'm allergic to cats. I broke my hand punching someone.
I once broke my hand punching Stephanie Kowalski in fifth grade. No way.
No way.
You knocked her the fuck out. I see you like to write notes to yourself.
I want a yoo-hoo now.
Helps me stay focused.
Alright, let's get a truth.
Also, sweet scar.
Alright. Now we got a truth. I wanted to be a pirate as a kid.
I used to want to be a pirate when I grew
up. I'll give her a free one.
I kind of still do. Arr.
And another tooth. I love science. That's cool that Chloe loves science. I wouldn't have guessed that about Chloe.
Seriously, I think Neil deGrasse Tyson is the
This is so crazy how they have real life references to certain products and things and games. And other things are...
You're hella mysterious, Chloe.
You're checking the hand.
Hella?
Rachel Amber.
It's a Cali
thing.
Anyway, I think I have your number. Of course you wanted to be a pirate. Sail the open seas.
Yeah. Every kid wants to be a pirate too, so.
Secret treasure.
Mm-hmm.
Did I mention my love of
all giggity?
So, pirate.
Obviously. R. Yeah, I'll do R.
Like you said, R.
I'm nervous about the flirting now.
Okay.
Because I think I want to let her take the lead on that.
But you are failing chemistry. You're saying failing chemistry means I hate
science? Hey, that's a good point.
Or that Blackwell doesn't inspire your best
That's... Blackwell's a hellhole. But she already knows that.
That place is a hellhole filled with shit. Where
Can't even not, oh my god, you didn't need to go that far.
Tell me how you really feel.
I know, right?
Anyway, school sucks, but you love science. I'm gonna say true.
Alright.
Now, about this broken hand
story. Yeah.
It's not that I don't think you could knock Stephanie Kowalski.
Uh-huh.
A bitch takes your yoo-hoo, she's gotta
damn
straight. But you didn't get that scar from punching someone. No. That scar is from a distal radius fracture.
How could you know that?
How could you possibly know that? I broke my wrist when I was 10. The point is, I know that the scar you've got comes with breaking your wrist when you fall. Like, from a skateboard? Yeah. I guess...
She's smart!
7. Well, shit. I always thought I was a good liar.
I wonder if she...
Good thing you're pretty.
Aww. That's what I should have waited for.
So, if my math is correct, you told me 2 truths and 1 lie. What? You expected me to cheat? Winners make their own rules, Chloe. You are crazy good at this game. A lifetime of studying the human condition.
It's kind of creepy. No, hell no, I'm impressed.
Well, I'm impressed.
Observers are the best kind of people for me.
I'm gonna feel good about that one. When your dad is the district attorney, I guess lying is something you're used to. Seriously? Seriously. I know who to call if I need to get out of a ticket then. Not that I have a right of my own. Car first, embarrassing number of moving violations second. Hey, thanks for trusting me. Trusting you? You played the game. And not everyone would admit to wanting to
be a pirate. Well, I thought that one was a freebie because every kid wants to be a pirate or is...
And rum is
True that.
I guess. You opened up a lot. That's all.
It's not a big deal.
For Chloe, it is.
Break it to you?
Yeah.
But Chloe Price is not exactly renowned throughout Arcadia Bay as a bastion of trust and empathy.
Trust is hard.
Trust doesn't exactly come easy to me.
From a Chloe perspective, trust is definitely hard.
No, I get that.
On the other hand, I got on this train with you, didn't I?
Fair point.
Are we gonna kiss now? Nope. That's why I'm not flirting anymore. Because I can't read these animations. Share with Ray. Yeah, fuck yeah, share. Absolutely share.
Hey, wanna listen?
One of my favorite things to do, listen to music together with somebody. Music is so powerful. And sharing moments is the easiest way to make a memory. It's a victory dance. Damn, dude. What a good return. And now we're just chilling until we leave. Yep. That's too good, man. We listen to like 10 seconds of the song and then I just like that. Like they give you the option to leave whenever you want. Because the scene hasn't really played out, you know?
I've had it, I guess, since I was a kid in Long Beach. Reminds me that there's more to experience out there than just...
Oh, hell yeah, there's always more to experience.
Maybe one day I'll go back to Long Beach. Or anywhere but here. Maybe sooner than later.
I hear ya.
Me too. Arcadia Bay can suck a bag of dicks.
Sometimes I feel like I've got no reason to stay.
That's why you're on a train headed north right now, right?
Chloe, if one day... I'm just out of here.
Let me know if you need an accomplice.
Check it out. We're here. What? Where is here? Jump and find
jump
out.
And...
Did you say jump? Did you say... Jump.
Jump.
Fuck it.
Damn. I'm having such a good time, man. I've had a smile on my face this whole time. It's amazing how watching these two become friends... makes me want to go find somebody to become friends with. It sounds stupid, but like these characters for me are so real. And it's crazy to be back in this universe. This game seriously like changed my outlook and changed my life in a lot of different ways. The first one is just, it's incredible. If I remember to, I'll leave a link in the description down below for it, like a direct Steam store link, so that way people don't even have to search. Still wondering where we're at. I mean, obviously some sort of wilderness park with trails and stuff. But nothing that I really know of. At least I don't think. Northwest Valor, 1992. Nice totem pole. So it is just like a picnic area, a viewpoint of sorts, a point of interest, whatever they would be called.
Hey. It's actually a pretty nice view.
Hell yeah.
Glad you approve. And as your reward for making it up here, I have a new game for us.
What's that?
Another one. I like games. Deal with it. This is one I learned in theater.
Okay.
It's
nice. Games, acting, lying.
So far, what I've learned about you is that you're into acting, lying, and playing games. What's your point?
Exactly.
That you're either full of imagination or full of shit.
Let me know when you figure out
that
which one.
Why would... God,
this
Chloe.
Game involves spying on people from afar. Luckily, we got some high-tech surveillance equipment.
I thought she was
going to
talk about the activities we had done, not be odd about it. Hi. There's another one over there. Doesn't look like it's working. Out of work. Aww.
Well.
Yeah. Shit. Are we out of coins now?
That was my last quarter.
Oh, come on. You... Please tell me I have a quarter. I could have found a quarter somewhere earlier today.
Hey, maybe I can MacGyver something up.
Maybe not.
I've been told I'm pretty
handy. Not then.
Oh, yeah?
Let's see what I got. What? Okay. All right, let's see what I got. Let's see what the land around me has. Maybe I find a quarter on the ground somewhere. Maybe I commit a felony and
Rachel really wants to use this viewfinder. I'd love to get it working for
her. All right, Mikey's texting us. Where's my phone? There we go. Mikey, there we go. Sorry about Drew, not your fault. My brother's not always an asshole. Just most of the time, forget it. I didn't need him to apologize on behalf of his brother. You don't need to apologize on behalf of other people. Like, you can comment on it and I don't know, it's just squirrels. Hey, no, I don't want to scare the squirrels. Dedication plate. There's got to be something around here that is going to help me get this done. Might as well look at it.
Blackwall guy sure liked founding stuff that was already there.
Yeah, nothing really on there.
Founders keepers, I guess.
Can I walk down here? No, I can't. What about over here? Yes, I can. Alright, so someplace around here.
I don't want to head down there.
Okay, sounds good. We'll find something else then. Maybe it's the other viewfinder or something like that. Hang on. Let me see here. Something going on with this. There's no tree down there. That's pretty cool. What if I look at this? What if I look at this down here?
This whole day is out of order.
Okay. Probably not going to do anything. The dedication plaque is the other thing that I'm looking at right here. Yep, this guy right here. Look at this.
I've always said the Prescott family has a couple screws loose.
All right, well, that didn't do anything. I was thinking to myself, maybe you could peel it off or something. Oh, hey.
I've been saying sorry all morning. I admit it was really dumb to lock the keys in the car. You've been on me for 3 hours.
When people dwell, man. Okay. Hey, what's going on, guys? How's it going? Can I borrow a quarter?
Hey, spare some change.
Sorry, we might have some leftover food when we're done.
What? No.
Change.
What kind of
spare change? You got to pay.
This has really gone downhill.
Shh. She's right.
Change.
There.
Not homeless, you fucks. Seriously, I can't just say I'm not homeless? Okay, whatever. Just wander around. Change! Change, give me wine! Change!
My hierarchy of needs goes pot, then beer, then wine. Still, wino has a classy ring.
Bird's nest, hey. I'll look at that.
There's gotta be something freeing about being able to build your home wherever you
are.
From whatever is around you.
Okay, can I talk to you again? No, probably not, and probably not you. Okay. We can do something now. I just don't know what it is. Initials. Yeah, let's look at this.
Yuck. Cliche much, AW and O.
Well, I mean, they're probably broken up by now, so you can not be cynical about it. They're probably both like three. Oh, actually.
I guess nature doesn't quite provide.
Okay, I think, what if I scare these guys off and they go down to the other guys?
Get out of here, woodland creatures. Have some self-respect.
Yeah. Go eat nuts. Not trash. Fucking birds, you too. Can I scare the birds off too? Get out of here. Birds.
Bye, you
fly fools. Away. Okay, that's it, right? And the okay, well, it looks like it's just a trade-off. It's one or the other. Oh my god. I don't know if I can do anything. Hang on. Rachel, can I talk to you yet?
Totally. Gonna get you that quarter. Love the confidence. Would love a quarter.
I'll find it, Rachel, but let me look at that
looks
one.
Looks like this one might actually be
okay,
working.
Can I look at the oak tree down there?
The lonely oak looks lonely. Guess even trees have out.
I think it looks pretty cool. It just can't hang with all the other ones. Gotta be set apart so that you can appreciate that one individually. Hey, there's another initial thing over here. I don't
need to get that.
Yeah, I know. Can I do anything actually with this one over here? Hang on. Have I been being a dumbass this whole time and I can just investigate? Okay.
Huh. Looks like I might be able to pry it open with
the right tool. I need the plaque. Okay. No, I gotcha. Now I need the dedication plaque. I just needed to trigger it by looking at it first and then go from there. Now I can use... Oh, no, come...
I wonder if I could use this to get
the Yeah, that's out. What I'm saying. Let's take it. Let's... How do I...
I wonder if I could use this to get the
Yeah, of course
out.
You can. How do I get it? Oh, damn it. Okay, I need to find something. Do you have a screwdriver, Rachel, by chance?
That is oh, the look
okay,
of a person
yep.
who is used to getting
I hit the wrong
wants.
Button.
Wonder what that feels like.
I hit the wrong button. Hey, Rachel, you have a screwdriver?
I'm thinking about prying open that viewfinder. Got a knife on you?
Yeah, or a screwdriver, flathead.
Yeah. My mom took mine. No.
Perf.
How about a...
Yes, nail file would be perfect. I just need to unscrew it. Thank you very much.
I guess you could stab someone with a
That's
nail
not
file.
What I need it for, Chloe. You don't have to... Yeah, exactly.
Oh, right. Sure, let's try it.
I love how she's like, don't say anything awkward, and then continuously says awkward things. Victoria! Chloe Price. I heard some fucked up shit from Nathan about you. Who do you think you are? He doesn't need you, you dumb fuck up. Go back to your trailer. By the way, Rachel Amber obviously played you last night. You'll be lucky if she ever talks to you again. Oh shit, why didn't I see that? I'm so hurt. This is just the beginning, bitch. That's right, this is just the prequel. This is the prequel. There's a lot of stuff to come after this. Whole lot of stuff. Thanks, Rachel. Good to see you too. Okay, let's unscrew this crap. Go get the stuff. I would have just loved to get a quarter from the couple that's arguing down there, but for some reason they think I'm a vagrant. Even though I'm wearing perfectly fine clothing. And I put deodorant on this morning. Or yesterday. I can't remember.
Stealing a dedication plate takes persistence.
Well, I mean, or just like searching around a whole lot. Steph, what's up? Hey, heads up. Wells is on the warpath. Oh no. Seriously. Okay. Just trying to help. Oh shit. Yeah, right. You killed me this morning. That's what the GM does, dude. Thanks for playing with us, Mikey. Had a blast. He's cool. Yeah, see, they didn't call him a dungeon master. They called him a grandmaster or whatever. It's been down late. I'm not sure why, but I enjoyed playing with them. I really enjoyed playing with them this morning. I'm glad I stuck around. And I'm glad they gave me the warning that if I left, it wouldn't have been able to continue. Okay, pry this bad boy open, get a fucking quarterback.
Prescott power. Activate.
It's like a $2,500 fine if I get convicted of vandalism in public property in a state park or government crap. There's only one quarter in there. That was the only quarter. Holy crap. Yeah, and we're doing it all for a quarter. One single quarter. It's out of order already, though. They're going to have to replace it, so whatever. And if anybody else falls victim to it, then there you go. And get their quarterback now. Not to brag.
I don't want to boast, so I'll let you do it for me. Chloe Price, you are truly the viewfinder whisperer. I stand in awe of your powers.
Damn right. There you go. Check it for a sign. Okay. We're lucky. What are we looking at? What's there to see?
Rachel smells like jasmine. Is she smelling me right now, too? Really should have showered this morning.
That's funny.
All right, here's the game. You find some people for us to spy on, and then you and I will act out what they're saying and thinking.
Okay.
That's it. I do that in my head during, like, every class. See? You're a natural.
Let's find some people. We obviously got them. Don't know what that is right there. Wait, is that literally what I'm supposed to look? Oh, no, there we go. Yep, look at you. Yes, there we go.
Think this guy's married to a nutritionist? He's all like, I'm not allowed to eat this stuff at home.
So he comes out here. I love grease.
I love grease. How can something that tastes so
be bad
good
for you
be so wrong? Oh, dropped a fry on my suit. Now I'll have to burn it. Good thing I have a giant squirrel costume.
Oh my god, he's a furry. That's funny. That's really funny. Okay, let me see here. It's a weird statue. Yeah, let's look at these guys. Look at you. There. Beautiful.
Alright. Let's see.
Let's switch hands.
Why do we always hold hands like this? Didn't you tell me you were ambidextrous? No, I didn't. I said I was ambisexual.
Oh, so you can have sex with both of your hands?
Exactly. Wanna see?
Only if you let go of my hand first.
Oh my god. I used to do this kind of shit all the time when I was in high school too. I was a quiet poet in the back. I didn't say much to anybody, so I just... I mean, I did. I was outgoing, but at the same time, I definitely wasn't. I don't know. I've always been weird.
What's going on with these two?
Child sacrifice.
And the Lord saideth, thou shalt make a burnt offering of your firstborn son.
Who are you talking to, Dad?
No one, son. Now, lean into the grill and see if the fire's set. Further.
Further.
Wow. That was dark. Too dark?
Nah.
Perfect.
Perfect dark. You adopted the darkness. I was born into it. Probably these guys.
Oh, sorry. Didn't mean to hog the viewfinder.
What are they doing, though? A nice tattoo.
Jackpot. Commence makeout session in 3, 2, 1.
Oh!
Nailed it. Damn, they are really going at it.
Yeah. Vibrating beds, prostitutes? No, I'll go vibrating beds.
Oh, honey. I think we used the vibrating bed for too long. I'm totally seeing double. Rachel?
Rachel? She knows one of them.
What are we doing?
Excuse me?
Last I checked, you're supposed to be Chloe Price. Yet we've been ditching now for hours, and we haven't even gotten wasted yet. That's got to be against some school ditching rule.
Huh. I'm still hungover. I'm in. She wants to do it, I'll do it.
Hell yeah. The honor student wants to show the school delinquent how to party?
Yeah.
Guessed.
How gracious of you.
She saw something she didn't want to see, I think. When things are nonsensical and then there are giant, like, gestures. Like what Chloe just did, where she just shrugs. She doesn't know what's going on.
They have a bottle
yes,
of
they
wine.
Do.
Let's
Okay.
Or we could go try to find a liquor store.
But how old are we?
No. You shouldn't bring alcohol to a public park if you're not willing to share it with everybody, right? And fuck it. I just want to take something that's not mine. All right. I'm going in. Try to keep up.
Okay.
Can we help you?
Oh, no, Rachel, what's happening? Somebody go help her now.
Holy shit.
Oh, my God, this is just crazy. Holy fuck. Rachel, keep looking at her. She needs you to look at her right now. Whoa. Could we stop fucking Mr. Magooing over to the wine?
Oh, thank God. Please, this girl is in trouble. Go get help.
Judge.
I need to get these two to focus on Rachel so I can swipe the wine.
What are you waiting for?
Change. Who's the one waiting?
Don't look at me. Look at Baywatch over here. I don't remember how to do CPR.
Why?
It's time to nut up.
What? Okay.
Up.
Watch out. I'm going to check her pulse. That's on her neck,
yes.
Right? I still think you should go get help. There's a ranger station on the other side of the park.
Good point. We'll keep watch while you go.
Okay, sounds good. Watch or die?
Look at all the time we've wasted already.
Right before? Oh my god.
Stat.
No, mouth to mouth.
Yep. Definitely it's mouth to mouth.
Okay.
I'm gonna hear about this later.
I can't do it.
Pathetic. Look. He's clearly useless. This woman needs help from someone who actually knows what they're doing.
Unlock your potential.
Hey, look at me. Do you want to be locked out of the car of life forever?
Yeah.
Or are you ready to break in there and seize the keys to your potential.
Bitch. Oh my god. You're right.
Is he gonna do it now? He mustered up the balls. It finally dropped on him. Yep, there we go. Mouth to mouth. He didn't commit.
Hey, wow. I'm all better now. You saved my life. From the bottom of my heart.
Yeah, see you later. Keep looking at the ground. Don't watch us while we walk away. Definitely don't have anything in my right hand. Okay, bye. Change.
That was incredible. You're a hero.
I can be your hero, baby. I can kiss away the pain. Oh, yeah. Are we really getting hammered out here? Like, it just kind of hit me.
You earned this.
Hand it over. Yeah.
Thanks.
I'm not gonna let her be a party pooper. Like, or I'm not gonna be a party pooper in front of Rachel after she just took a giant ass swig.
I could use a drink after trying to keep up with you.
Oh my god, are we getting schnockered here? Rachel?
I'm excessively
sober. Give it 5.
Right. Okay. Guess we're leaving now.
Something's going on with Rachel. I don't know what it is. God, I'm so happy to be back in this universe, man. Like, this is a blast. I'm having such a good time. I'm concerned for the characters again like I was before, but it just... It's the feeling that you get when you visit a town that you haven't been to in a while and you go see all your favorite spots. You see all your friends that live there. I don't know. There's just something about this game, man. I love it. How much wine is in that bottle exactly? I'm sorry. And how many fucking squirrels are there in this actually, that's a decently logical thing to assume that there are going to be a lot of squirrels in the forest. The junkyard. Oh shit. Oh shit. Oh shit, I forgot about the junkyard. Wow. After you.
Great.
It's a junkyard.
Yeah, an awesome pile of trash.
Yeah, explore.
You have fun, Chloe.
It'll be fun. You're drunk.
Rachel's been acting kind of standoffish ever since we left the park.
She saw something. Like, she definitely saw something. I wonder if she knew one of the people. I don't want to call her out. I just want to talk to her about it. Why does it say call her out? Just ask her. That's the prefer. God damn it. Call her out. I want to know what's going on. Oh, I really, I like, and I would ask. I would ask in real life. I would absolutely ask.
I've heard that actors are moody, but...
You don't have to be a dick about it.
I'm not moody. I just need some space. Is that all right with you? Okay. Actually, no. I thought we were having a great day together. Why are you acting like this all of a sudden? I'm not acting like anything. I just want to be left alone right now.
I don't understand. Like...
No. I don't understand. You can't just turn on me for no reason. I'm sorry. Turn on you? I guess I forgot. It's always about how you feel, isn't it? Sad Chloe's fucking sad again. Maybe you should try giving a shit about other people for once. Are you serious right now? Fuck!
How did this blow up so fast?
Okay, I still have no idea what's going on with Rachel, but...
Apparently she gets smashy when she's angry. That's funny.
I can work with that.
What? No, you're not supposed to get smashy when you get angry. Oh, okay. Actually, never mind. We're in a junkyard. That was a very conveniently placed baseball bat. Give Rachel a show. That's what I would do.
Hey, check it out.
I don't always drink beer, but when I do, I prefer drinking it next to an old toilet. Home run!
You didn't even break the bottle.
Can I see?
Sure.
I asked you to leave me alone. Are you kidding me?
What the fuck?
I know you're the school princess and all, with the DA daddy and the perfect grades and all the perfect little Victoria Chases kissing your perfect ass, but seriously?
No, you don't have to.
Great. I'm leaving. See you.
God, that
please.
Happens so much,
leave.
Man.
Watch me. Rachel,
people
wait.
Just need to say what's on their don't mind. Go. And have a little bit more empathy if you're trying to.
Why not?
What do you mean, why not?
Because I don't want to ruin this the way I ruin everything else in my life. And what is this exactly?
What's it to you? It's I think she might have got mad because I stopped being flirty and stuff, but
are you actually going to make me say it?
Say what? Exactly.
You know, like a friendship. But more.
Ah. I know. Weird, right? It's just today was the best day I've had since my dad died. And when I almost ruined it just now, the way I ruin everything, it made me realize whatever's going on between us is special.
It's a fair point.
Come on, say something. Chloe, you know what? Forget it. This was really stupid. I mean, you're Rachel Amber, and I'm Chloe Price. It's not that. It's just hard right now. And I can't
clearly
talk about it. Why not? Because I can't. I know it isn't fair, but it's how it is. Goodbye, Chloe.
Was so up and down, like out of nowhere. And I don't even understand what it was that she saw. I'm trying to think about the tattoo if that had any significance, but I can't figure it out. I really just can't. Not anything I can think of at the very least. Oh snap. Here we go. Yep.
Fuck this.
Yeah, that. Oh my god. Smash. Chloe, smash! I'm surprised I didn't even smash it because of the impact. Sign. Yes, smash the sign. I didn't think that we'd actually knock it down, but holy hell. Okay, we did. Let's go to the wooden box over here. Fucking A, she's mad. She is mad. I got a text.
If you want to rip a family apart from the inside, it's important to bring the proper
yep.
tools.
Sorry for hitting the mic there, guys. I just realized I did that.
Fuck you, David.
Oh, snap, dudes. This is,
you know she's fake. You can't take your eyes off her. Who else do I know who fits that description? Yeah! Fuck off, Rachel.
She's not happy. And I also took the path with Chloe that led to believing it was something more.
Your heart on for cameras, Max. You took a million pictures of us, and not one of them showed that you were gonna leave when I needed you most. Fuck cameras.
Shit. This straight up just shows what she went through while Max was gone. Like, being betrayed after she already felt like she was betrayed. What? What?
Dad.
What? The car. Seriously? Is that the car? That's the car. Oh my God, the blood. In all reality, I don't even know if that would still be around after so much time has passed. This just shows everything that she went through. She felt betrayed by Max, and then Chloe just up and leaves her, and then that. Nobody could have predicted that. That's the end of the first one, isn't it? That totally is, isn't it? Dream sequence. We gotta be in the same one as before.
Why are you crying, sweetheart?
Or maybe not. Oh God, the Raven.
Because you're not real.
I'm not.
What is going on?
You know, you don't doubt when you have moments like that.
What's
you don't say something's not real if you see it.
Prologue and shit.
Kiddo, look on the bright side, would ya?
What bright side?
You made a new friend today.
True that, but I don't know if I kept him. You gotta keep the friendship until the next day. What's behind it? I don't think I want to graffiti that. The wine bottle, the mannequin.
I guess I did that?
Yep.
Gotta say, that was some fight. A lover's quarrel, you might say? She nearly took your head off.
Keep passing by, Rachel.
What do you care?
Sorry, sweetheart. I guess I'm getting into your personal business.
I don't feel drunk.
It's all put back together. I was gonna say, I remember it breaking.
Sometimes people need you, though. Even when they don't admit it.
They should. It's the truth that they don't, but they should.
Hmm.
They'd find more help if they asked for it.
Rachel.
Wow. Are we getting back into it? Holy shit, we are. Oh my god, man! I remembered the episodes being long, but I didn't remember them being, like, telltale long. Keep in mind, though, I still have that 10 minutes in there where I was wandering around aimlessly trying to figure out the very first solution to the puzzle, which was just talking to the bouncer about his bike and the floral paint job. I don't understand how I missed that, but, yeah. That would really suck to see that after so many years of grief and moving on, and then to just have it dropped right in front of you again. I'll start the whole process over practically, at least for a few minutes. Wonder if anything would have been different if I wore the other shirt. Damn. A lot of tiny little side scene cutscenes. I don't remember there being this many loading screens in the last one. I wonder if that's because of the graphics overhaul and everything. How the game just inherently looks a hell of a lot better with, you know, sun rays, and everything's turned on high right now, so. And damn near everything is a cutscene as well, so I guess that makes sense.
You came. I'm glad.
Hey. I couldn't let the day end with whatever this afternoon was.
Chloe, I want to talk to you about something, but I don't know how to talk about this.
You don't have to tell me anything you don't want to.
You remember that guy that we saw under this tree with that woman?
The ones who were making out?
That was my dad.
Oh. All right.
Oh, shit.
And that woman was definitely not my mom.
Oh.
The worst part is, I'm not surprised. I felt like my dad's been lying about something for a while. I didn't know what it was.
That's really low.
So when I saw he got a text from an unknown number asking him to meet, I thought I could catch him or something.
Really? So that's why she wanted to come out here. That's why she wanted company.
I'm so sorry.
That makes sense now.
I don't know what to say.
Neither do I.
Nobody does.
Chloe, I love my dad. I love him. And I never want to see his fucking face again.
When my dad died, I was so mad at him. For months, I felt wrong because half the time I thought of him, I wanted to scream. And the other half, I forgot.
Forgot that anything had changed. It's silly, but I've carried this photo around with me for years.
The one we found earlier, isn't it?
It's from Mount Hood. My dad took me hiking there when I was 10, and it started raining, and I fell and broke my arm 3 miles from the car. I remember screaming like I was gonna die, but my dad, he carried me down the mountain. I still remember the smell of his coat and how calm he was, and the sound of his voice, and
He was just so strong, you know? I felt safe.
You trusted him.
Completely.
Here.
Broke that trust today.
Chloe, I owe you an apology.
Hey, we were both kind of the queen of shitty.
No, I mean it. Whatever's going on between us, it's intense and new and awesome, and you had the courage to tell me that you feel it too. And I treated you like shit.
Courage? I don't know if I'd call it that. More like blind desperation. And maybe a slight buzz from that wine.
I just want you to know, I'm lucky that you were with me today. You're a badass, Chloe Price.
What?
Remember that biker asshole who wouldn't let you into the mill? You talked your way right past him.
You saw that?
And those skeevy douchebags who followed you upstairs? Two against one. But you wouldn't take any
shit. Never take shit from anybody.
I'd be dead if you hadn't thrown that.
That's
bomb.
True. Never take
you
shit from anybody.
What about Drew? When he was picking on Nathan? You got right in his face and called him out.
That was pretty sweet.
Yeah, I did
actually.
Have fun with that one too.
See? You're the real thing, Chloe. I don't know anyone like you. Plus, you came along with me, no questions asked.
Well, I don't really need a good reason to ditch.
There was more to it than that, though.
I guess tomorrow they'll be
nah.
Helping.
My mom might skip grounding and just go straight to the...
Yeah, they do live in a state where that's, I think, still a thing.
Will definitely punish me with...
Fuck your dad.
Fuck him.
Yep.
What I wouldn't give to leave this place and never look back.
What's stopping us?
Us? Are you serious?
There's nothing keeping me here. Not anymore.
So, if I came to you tomorrow and told you to pack your bags...
I'm serious. Let's do it, Chloe. Let's leave this place forever.
Okay.
Damn. They were both ready. I didn't realize that Max was still such a prevalent focus of Chloe's mind.
Can I borrow your lighter?
I mean, Max did a lot to...
Thank you.
Max did a lot to essentially guarantee that Chloe was going to have... Oh, God. Was going to have a hard time trusting people. Dude. Trust is everything, man. You break that... He can fuck everything up.
Come on.
I think we should bounce. Oh shit. That's gotta be the end right there, right? What? For real? I need to stop calling it. I'm usually pretty good about calling it, but I guess not. Oh wow, that's a hell of a lot closer than... Holy crap. I wanna go back and play more of that game. And this kinda reminds me of the end of, I think it was the first episode. I think. There was this sequence where... It was snowing, and they basically went around to each of the characters and showed their reaction to the snow. And I still can't figure out for the life of me who that person is with the tattoo. But we're gonna find out. That was one hell of an episode, man. What a good fucking episode. Awake. Dear Heart, achievement unlocked. You guys, I fucking love this game. I love it so much. And it's gonna tug at your heartstrings, I can almost guarantee it. If I were you, and you made it all the way through, and you have not seen the other Life is Strange, unless you want to binge watch it, unless you want to binge play it, unless you have the time to binge play it, I would say try to see what it's like to enjoy this series as a prequel. Because I can see how everything is tying together now. And this basically paints Chloe's picture of how she was and what happened to make Chloe Chloe. And I don't know, it's just, it's so nice to be back in this universe and to see what everybody is like at this point in time, because assumptions were made about everything regarding this. It all had to do with the minimal backstory that was provided, and sometimes you can't really draw every conclusion from what's given to you. And that's why I'm so happy to see this. I mean, granted, it's a tragic story, but I can actually see it for what it was and what really happened and put the context all together, as opposed to just having this vision of what happened. I used to always think that Chloe was just a very abrasive individual, but she has a hell of a lot of justification behind where that comes from. She has her reasons, and that's not something that many people can say. So to actually see it happen and to see the relationship with Rachel evolve, I am thrilled that they decided to do this, and I cannot wait to see what comes in the next two episodes. If I remember, I'm gonna put a link directly to the original game, the first one, down in the description below, so that you can get a direct link to pick it up. It's fantastic. There are, if memory serves, 5 episodes, and they are equally as long as this one was, on the par, you know, of 2 hours, 2.5 hours, depending on how much time you spend with them. But either way, you guys, that's gonna do it for this one. If you made it this far, please leave a like down below and support the series. Let me know what you enjoyed. What was your favorite part? Leave a comment down below and let me know. And let me know if you've also played the beginning. Or not the beginning, but the other one. I'm curious to know who is actually in the know with me as to all of the previous happenings and events. But you know what? Actually, let's give me a second, you guys. I'm gonna wait until the end of the credits. We'll see if there's something at the end. All right, turns out that there's the percentage screen. I completely forgot about it. So let's go over all of our choices and stuff like that. We got all of our stats. That was some long credits, but I was sticking out until the end to make sure that there wasn't any scene. So we got 39%, you ran, 60% was kind to Joyce. I figured running would be better. I mean, when you think about it, you guys, you're on, just to make my case, like you're... you're on a unstable ground sort of setting. There's, you know, planks that are sticking up here and there. So if you run your attacker, there's a decent chance that as they go after you, they're going to trip up over whatever you successfully navigate around. Of course, we defended Nathan. Everybody should have. And you told Rachel that you are more than just friends. I had a feeling that most people did that. All right, let's go to next. You didn't take the money. I didn't know there was money. You didn't purchase weed from Frank. I didn't really want to. Didn't read Joyce's self-help book. You didn't put the photo of William on the dresser. You didn't slip money. See, these all are tiny little choices that just kind of pop up as you progress through the areas. You didn't sabotage Victoria's homework. There was so much stuff. You finished the tabletop game with Steph and Mikey. 75% of people finished that game. Damn. I would have fucking loved. Oh, man. I wonder how many different outcomes that game could have had. I'm going to have to research some stuff. But I do believe you guys that that is it. Like I said, these are all tiny little things that you can do along the way that are kind of optional. I'm going to try to do a little bit more of them next time. It'll make the episode on par with 2.5 to 3 hours, but it's definitely worth it to find those other little tiny things in the episode. So anyway, guys, thanks for watching all the way until the end. Leave a like down below if you made it this far. I'll catch you all in the next one. So friends, if you enjoy what you see, and only if, leave a little love in the comment section or leave a like and subscribe so you don't miss the rest of whatever the hell comes next. And as usual, enjoy the rest of your day, and I will see you guys again. Uh-oh. Oh my god.
No one.
Oh no!
Me. I want my fucking money!
I didn't think there was gonna be a cinematic, and then there was. All right, guys, for real now this time. See you later. Enjoy the rest of your day, and I'll see you guys again.